Brad Storm here with MMAMayhemRadio.com. We're in lovely Montgomery, Alabama. Strike Hard 25. And you know what? We have the new Advanced Amateur Heavyweight Champion, Malcolm Megatron Hardman. Congratulations,
my friend.
Thank you so much. You had a tough opponent. You faced him off round one. Looks like you got the best of him. Why don't you explain to the fans?
Well, we came out. I knew he was a really good boxer, so I didn't want to, you know, necessarily exchange with him. I felt like his boxing really wasn't, that wasn't my, my boxing wasn't as far as his. We got into a clinch, you know, and I accidentally threw an illegal knee, gave him a low blow, and you know he had to take some time for that. And I noticed that he had went to the ground earlier, and
you did. Yeah, I wanted to explain to the fans really quick. You went to the ground. He tried to take you down, and you spun him around, and you got top position on that.
Yeah. He tried to get a sweep on me, and it was mostly it wasn't exactly technique. It was more of a strength move.
Right.
You know, I was able to kind of, you know, I had an underhook on the right side, and I was able to kind of twist him around and wound up in on top, and that's where that took off. That's where that knockout came from. So,
you know, you explain to the fans too. Like, I got to tell the fans how outstanding it was. You got on top of them, full mount, and you were relentless in your assault. It was just, you delivered the pain on that one, so to speak, and you knocked him out.
Well, my trainer, Shane Mills, he told me, you know, you just go in there and you unleash. You just attack. And that was my game plan. Just keep on attacking. You know, don't stop. You know, whenever we went into clinch, I made sure to just keep on throwing knees. I could hear him grunting. I could tell it was taking a lot out of him. So, you know, I figured that was a good idea. And him trying to take me down turned out to be the best thing that happened, you know.
Right. And you talk about Shane Mills. You talk about Childersburg MMA.
Cage Fit.
They changed the name? Cage Fit?
It was from Auburn, Alabama, and Cage Fit.
Okay, correction. It's going to be Cage Fit fan, so you better get that straight. I don't want you to knock me out. But as far as Cage Fit goes, who else besides Shane Mills has improved your skills in the cage?
We got Shane Mills, Keith Johnson, who's actually the main event of tonight's fight. He's also my trainer. Fantastic wrestler. Amazing at jiu-jitsu, you know, so we spend a lot of time on the ground there. Shane, he's actually my striking coach, you know, so that's really good. And we also have Dallas Garz, who was going to be on the event tonight, but he got scratched out for an injury.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, I know, right? But he's also really good at wrestling, you know, so we have a good little wrestling background as far as Cage Fit goes, and which is actually a relatively new gym.
Right.
So, you know, we're just trying to piece it all together so we can produce some good fighters, and her seems to be working out.
Well, it looks like you got the gold, my friend.
Yes,
who's up next for you for a Strike Hard?
Well, I guess the heavyweight challenger, you know, whoever Strike Hard wants to put in front of me.
Yeah.
I actually normally fight at light heavyweight.
Okay.
So I want to go back down there, but I mean, I might dabble in heavyweight a little bit now, you know. So
right.
It seems to be a good idea for me.
I think so.
And,
as far as sponsorships, any affiliates you want to make mention of?
I don't have any sponsorships. I will mention F3 Nutrition, though. You guys need to check them out, F3 Nutrition, and actually Take Life by the Throat. There you go.
Take Life by the Throat.
Yes,
and you know, you're going to want to follow MMA Mayhem Radio on Twitter. At MMA Mayhem Radio, you're going to want to watch out, because if you're going to challenge for this belt, Megatron is going to beat you down.